Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Have faith, my friend. You need only state your case with confidence and clarity.
Commander Leveillard. It is both an honor and a pleasure to meet you. I am Emmerich, Lord Commander of the Temple Knights.
Alphino Leveilleur, at your service. Your reputation precedes you, Sir Emmerich. I think we will find that we have much in common.
Speaking of reputations, yours towers over us all, does it not?
It does indeed, Lord Commander.
I am not too proud to admit that I have followed your activities with an interest bordering on fascination. Full glad was I to learn that you would be joining us. Now then, shall we begin?
We know full well that the Garleans will return in force ere long. What is more, we have yet to achieve a lasting victory over the primal menace. The beast tribes continue to summon their gods, and each incarnation is stronger than the last. Ishgard is not immune to these threats. I must reiterate that it would behoove your nation to rejoin the Eorzean Alliance.
Once again, I must respectfully disagree.
On what grounds?
Despite their presence in Kerthus, the Ixil do not concern us. Their territorial claims pertain to Gridanian lands, and it is the people of Gridania whom they harry. Consequently, the Holy See judges this to be a Gridanian affair, and Ishgard does not intervene in the internal affairs of other nations. Even were that not the case, our forces are wholly committed to the Dravanian conflict. We have not the knights to spare. As for the Garleans, we are not ignorant of history. We have observed the rise and expansion of the Empire, and we agree that it is only a matter of time before they resume their campaign in Eorzea.
Then surely it would be in our best interests to present a united front.
Mayhap one day, but not yet. Gaius van Belsar is dead, and the legion of conscripts he left behind lacks the will to fight. We think it highly unlikely that they will emerge from behind the walls of their castra for some time.
Forgive me, but if Ishgard's position has not changed, why did you agree to this meeting?
It was not only as a representative of Ishgard that I came here.
Pardon?
It is not within my power to change Ishgardian policy, regardless of my personal feelings. There is, however, one area in which I may exert a measure of influence. Concerns have been raised over the supplies House Fortin has offered to Revenant's Tall. These have led to calls for restrictions on the provision of aid to foreign powers. I can ensure that the shipments continue unabated.
Sir Emmerich, we would be in your debt.
No, you would not. For I require something in exchange. Of late, there has been a flurry of Dravanian activity, the purpose of which was not immediately clear. However, our astrologians have since observed alarming changes in the heavens. The dragon star waxes unnaturally bright, and there are whispers that it portends the resurrection of Midgard Sorma.
The fallen guardian of Silver Tear Falls? That's absurd.
Full many times have I gazed upon the dragon's corpse still wound around the Agrius, and wondered how different our world might be if it yet lived to plague the skies. I do not know, and I do not wish to know, nor does any son of Ishgard. Yet the mere presence of Dravanian forces is not sufficient grounds to send knights to Mordona, whatever our astrologians say. As I told you before, we have not the forces to spare.
But we do. So you will intervene on our behalf if we agree to watch over the Keeper of the Lake.
Do you accept these terms?
I do. I will see that you are kept abreast of any developments. I regret that we could not come to a similar agreement on other matters, but I understand that you are not at liberty to make such decisions. Nevertheless, I hope that what we have accomplished here today will serve to demonstrate to your countrymen that we can work together towards a common goal. Mayhap one day we shall look back on this moment as the first step towards a united Eorzea.
Mayhap we shall, Commander.
What is the meaning of this?
The caravan, my lord. It's been attacked. It was Iceheart, my lord.
What? By the Fury! All our precautions were for naught?
Ah!